I am not a liar. I have killed thousands. I have fed more drug fiends than the top three pharmaceutical companies combined. I have stolen children from parents, wives from husbands, wiped out entire generations. But lying? That I have never done. The rest are offenses against humanity. Lying is an offense against yourself. I am the head of the Santa Blanca organization, which you call a cartel. I had a dream. I dreamed of a land where we could grow our own coca, produce our own cocaine, where we could run our business free from interference from the police, the government, the army, the Yankees. In my dream, a woman's voice asked me,
"Sueño, mijo, what if you had your own country?"
Like Moses, I led my people to the promised land, Bolivia. We came here. We bought the coca fields. What we couldn't buy, we took. We bought the police, the military, the judges, the politicians. We were on the verge of becoming the government itself. On the razor's edge from fulfilling my dream. Of creating a narco-state. The nation of Santa Blanca.
Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian special forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece. The cartel is organized into four operations: production, smuggling, security, and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses, El Sueño.
All right, guys, welcome to Ghost Recon Wildlands. Sorry, my voice is a bit weird today, but today is the day of release of this game. I tend to not record videos like this until the game is officially released, and I don't do much until then. Right, so we can choose male or female. We're going to quickly make our character here. I did play the beta, just to let you guys know. Well, it was the open beta, it was a week ago, I think. I played it and it was good, and I decided to buy this game, which I have. And I decided to make videos on it too, so here we are. Right, okay, so let's pick our guy. I kind of want to make him like my character I had on, in the beta. I don't remember what number he was though. Oh, this is where I've got to remember. I think it might have been... I think it was him. We'll go with him. I'm happy with him. Right, okay, so we'll do eye color. I'm going to go with blue because my eyes are blue and I prefer to have blue eyes in video games, so I don't know why. Facial hair. Nope, we're not going to have a lumberjack. We're going to have... let's see if they've got any new ones here. Right, we're not going to have a tash here. We're going to have that. I'm happy with that. Right, hair. I didn't go with that. I think it was that. Yep, we're gonna go with that. Hair color. Stop listening. I swear down that, she keeps on popping up all the time now. I would just sit here, you know, and I'll just be like, oh, okay, it's that one. And then, like, I'm picking something or something, and then she'll pop up. I don't know what it is with her. Right, I don't think I went with any scars, and that'll do. Okay, so let's go on to appearance. The body stuff, I could say. Right, so, face paint, I didn't have anything like that on when I was playing it. I kind of just wanted the same old guy. Tattoos? I never actually went down the tattoos. Oh wow, okay, some of these tattoos are actually pretty cool. Oh, there it is. We're not going to have any tattoos. Alright, so let's go into clothes. So, right. This is where I don't remember what I had in the beta. Like, I really preferred what I had on in the beta. It was actually quite cool. But then yet again, I did sit around and make my character over the course of maybe about 20, 30 minutes here. But I don't really want to do that here. I'm just having a look at all the items here. Those are locked. Alright, let's have a look at these. Alright, what are these changing? Okay. Okay, I'm kind of liking that, so let's go with that. Right, let's go back into shirts here. Right, so we've got a t-shirt, and what I want to do is I want to stick on all black, I think. Yeah. Let's go with that. I'm going to go with that, but I'm going to go full on black, I think. Actually, no, let's keep looking. I want to find something a little bit more. Yeah, that's what I want to go with. Alright, pants. Alright. Oh, let's start at the top and work our way down. Alright. I kind of like them. I might go with them. Let's just have a look to see what else they got. By the way, guys, I didn't record the beta just because, oh, wow, okay. Ghillie suit. Part A of a ghillie suit. That's pretty cool. Alright, these are all locked. So what I am going to do is I am going to go with Something like this, but not those. I want to go with... yeah, probably those, but black. Yeah, those will do. Right, I'm happy with those. Footwear. Probably some combat boots would probably do. Alright, so there we go. We can now put on like a bit of a ghillie suit. But we're not going to be wearing a ghillie suit. Alright, so accessories. So, eyewear. Let's have a quick look here, shall we? I think those look pretty cool. We'll go with those. Face wear. Not so much. Alright, is he going airsofting, is he? Alright, those are all locked. Yeah, I don't really want anything on his face, so... I'm trying to go for the same pretty much look what I had for the beta here. I think I was wearing that. We'll go with that. Stop listening. Anyway, what we'll do is we'll keep on looking down while we go, just to see if there's anything else in here I might like rather than that. Cowboy hat. Alright, they're all locked, so yeah, I'm good. Headsets? New. Hand gear, yes. Let's go with some of these. Let's go with those. Put them in black. He's going to be sweating, but... oh, wow, we can even do backpacks. Okay, that's quite cool. I think they added new stuff in here as well. I kind of like that backpack, so let's go with that. Alright, Alright, one other thing I want to go with is I want to change the color of his chest rig. Which was in here somewhere. Yeah. There it is. Found it. There we go. That actually looks really cool. I like that a lot. Alright, I'm happy with him. Hope everybody else is too. Alright, let's that's my character, guys. So if you want to copy them, go ahead. Oh, actually, I want to change the backpack, don't I? Backpack color. I want it to be black. Accessories, backpack, and change you to black. I want it all to be uniform. There we go. I'm happy with that. All right, guys, there we go. Character customization done. I hope you guys enjoyed that little customized character thing. Gender, blah, blah, blah. Okay. I'm not bothered about that. Okay, difficulty will go on reg. Why not? So, here we go, guys. Welcome to Ghost Recon Wildlands. I said Recon wrong. If you guys didn't make that out. Sometimes when I listen to myself back, I don't hear it, but I do. I can physically hear myself saying it wrong. Anyway, loading screen on the next gen. They said they weren't going to put those things in, but they are. And they're still as long. Oh, here we go. We've got a percentage now. There we go. 100%. Here we go. Ubisoft presents.
The agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country?
I flew in business class from Manaus.
Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ass.
Guys, I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
Huh, you should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. Religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pak Qatari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Soldiers, this is the help you promised, that Sandoval promised. A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pak Qatari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he's in this province and that there's a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Okie dokie, guys. Welcome to Ghost Recon Wildlands yet again. Time is passing us by. There we go. Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands. I love Tom Clancy's games. Alright, so we're going over there. So first things first is I want to change up a couple of things. I want to change my loadout here very quickly. I'm going to change this from a submachine gun, hopefully to a sniper rifle. And it doesn't look like I can. It doesn't look like I've got any yet. Yep, it doesn't look like we've got any sniper rifles yet. That kind of sucks. Okay, that's fine.
Time to earn right, your pay, and people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pak Qataris and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and the firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Hoo-ah.
Alright, so what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to quickly go into options. Actually, no, I'm not. I was going to change up a control because I wanted to switch the bumpers, but what I'm going to do is, because I can change the bumpers on my controller settings.
Hang on, I'll drive.
A bit later, I will do that. Alright, we'll turn off the radio as well so we don't get copywritten. As I do with every video game I play, I get copywritten too much. Whoa. Okay, I forgot how weird the driving is in this, but we'll do the first couple of missions here. We'll have a bit of fun. I also know what skills I want to go for straight away. I want to go for the skill where you can get your guys to snipe more than one person at the same time. Or kill the same people, synchronized kill pretty much. That comes in handy way too much. Also, I have knocked the gamma right up on this game, so I hope it isn't too high for you guys. And I hope it isn't too whited out, I guess. If it is, I can kind of fix that in editing, I guess. I just have to be careful not to change it. Because if I change it, then I have to change everything. My editing. Right, so we're a few meters away. I can't even see that yellow writing right now because of the white sky. Right, we're almost there. This is exactly the same as the beta was. Alright, we're here. Right, let's head on in. Oh, that was remove suppressor. Wrong button. That one I want. Okay, so tutorial. Okay, we'll go through the tutorials, why not? So, take your time to mark enemies, use the drone and binoculars. Okay. Right. Okay, so the drone is up on the D-pad, I believe.
The drone is up.
Yep. Okay, there we go. He's marked.
Just spotted one with submachine guns.
Got eyes on the target. Let's move.
Okay, there we go. Right, and on the D-pad to remove. Okay, right, okay, let's get this guy.
Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
Yeah, we've got suppressors on, I believe. Yep. We got the big dildo on the end of our gun, so we're good. Right, I'll just make sure I shoot him in the head.
He's history.
Nice shot. This is exactly how I did it when I played the beta by myself. I didn't want to play the beta on my own, guys. That's why there was no videos of it. I wanted to check out the game and just play it at my own pace. Right, so tutorial. Synchronized shoot. Here we go. So aim at a target, press A to sync mark it. Shoot or hold A to pretty much give the order to shoot. Okay. So I can just aim and press A.
Got it, moving.
Nice. So we're gonna take out this guy, he's gonna take out
Ready.
That one.
Call the shot.
Okay.
Fuck, engage.
Get down.
Okay, there you go, the bullet's down. Easy peasy. Also, there's a cooldown as well for the synchronized shoot. It's like 20 seconds, not too long. I also want to kind of max that out, so we've got pretty much all of our guys. Like, right now, we're only synchronized shooting with one guy. Right now, for orders, it's this one. Okay, let's get a regroup going.
Rally up, people.
Roger, move it.
Oh, actually, there's gear here. Grabbing these early on's actually really good.
We'll leave a marker so the rebels can pick up these supplies later.
Grabbing those if you see them is actually really good. There's one right here, and I think it's here. It's these medical supplies. I didn't see these on my first playthrough. I just saw them right then. Right, so okay, we've got one guy there.
Yo, cartel gunman, near the watchtower.
Right, let's plop this beauty up and make sure we've got everybody. Okay, so we can easily take out this guy. What we'll do is we'll mark this guy.
Say the word.
Not yet.
That's a kill.
Nice shooting.
Okay, we're still good.
Alright, now we need to get that guy.
Eyes on a narco with a submachine gun.
I don't see him.
We'll grab these supplies on our way out. Well, actually, we could do them now. Just that guy's over there. He's not going to bother us. There we go. We'll grab them. Shit, he's just moved.
Get that
right, grab.
Okay,
there we go. Figured out the buttons. Alright. We'll take him inside. Alright, we'll interrogate. Let's go.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. No entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón! What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
Okay.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, they've been working on him for a while. There's a good chance he's already dead. Maybe, maybe not. Amaru is a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move.
Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to fall back to our car, which we left down here. And we'll go from there. Right, what I'm also going to do is I'm also going to call up a regroup.
A copy. Moving.
So our guys are on us and everything.
Let's get moving. Cartel isn't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Alright. Our car should be right here. Alright. Let's jump on in. So one thing we need to be really cautious about is the uni lads. If we get like caught by those, they'll just keep on calling them reinforcements after reinforcements after reinforcements, and then we've either got to somehow get away from them, or we've got to, I don't know, just get away from them. That or it's literally die and restart. Like when I was in the beta and I played the beta and stuff, like that thing was like, I had those people after us for about an hour and I was killing them an hour later. So. You better not get caught by those guys. Also, I did make a controller layout as well for this game, so if you guys are wondering how I'm getting used to this really quick, it's because I'm used to the controls.
What about your kids? My kids lie to me every fucking chance they get.
Whoa, which way are we going? This way. Yeah, so I've got a controller layout on, so I'm used to this game. It's pretty much like my Call of Duty layout and stuff like that. I use tactical button on that. So. Or it's more or less the same as Battlefield is. I like crouch on the thumbstick, not on B. Having it set, well, I had to set it up like that for the beta because I couldn't play it otherwise. Alright, we're pretty much here and there's a enemy car right ahead of us here. We're only a few meters away, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna sneak on in, hopefully kill a few guys, and I want to get a sniper rifle. We'll pull in here, we'll put up a drone, and we'll start taking them out. All right. Alright, stealth tutorial. Here we go. Right, so double press Y for handgun. For stealth approach, press B to crouch. Okay, so crouching is, or prone is better for stealth. So standing up isn't. We get detected quicker, I think, as well if we stood up. And, alright, not telling us about the detection meter. Okie dokie. Right, we're gonna lie here in our red hot black outfit, and we're gonna put up a drone and then scout out the area here at
Taz. Tango marked. He's a little close to civilians.
This guy there. There's a guy there. Two there.
That makes five.
Another one there. Another one there. Oh, and we're getting out of range of. Wow, okay. I'm so used to just being able to fly this thing all over the place. Especially with Watch Dogs. Alright. We're going to cross over the roads and move in a tad.
Coming up on a Toyo farm. Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
Alright, I'm moving in. Alright, let's move over here. Right. Okay, also there's a gun there if you see it. We need to pick up as many of them as possible because that'll help us out. Alright. What I'm going to do is I'm going to try and kill this guy. Okay, cross. Get him first, he's out in the open.
That's a kill.
Alright, Yep, there we go, level 2. We just leveled up. So what I am going to try and do, guys, in this game, I am going to try and go full stealth. If you guys don't like that type of thing, we will be going full auto at times. Alright, we're going to have to kill this guy and that guy.
Hostile down.
Alright, kill him. Yep, we're looking at about 3 guys. 4 guys. Right, okay, I'm happy. Right, let's move around here and let's
check it out.
We'll start right. Cool.
Target down.
We're cool. Yep.
This will go nice. Take my this. Boots.
Okay, there's one guy in there, and then there's the last guy, and then that's it.
Hostile down.
Sé que alguien me escucha, cabrones. Sé que están ahí.
All right, there we go. We're clear.
La rebelión no perdona.
Todavía no estamos a salvo.
Hey, how's it going, buddy? Come on out. Oh no, we need to come in here and talk to you, do it? Okay, we need to lead you.
What's left of him anyway? Come on, we're getting you out of here.
Come on. Right, we'll grab these supplies here too. Just around here. It's always best to grab these while you can, especially in the beginning part of the game. They come in useful later on. And we'll take this helicopter too. Alright, we'll drive. Oh. Nope, sorry, I need to lead. And then... this drive system's very clunky.
I got it, I'll fly.
Everybody in. Alright, let's just do the tutorial. So, press and hold right trigger to throttle up. Use left trigger to throttle down. That to move. Release that and move to rotate faster. Okay, got it. Everybody in. Alright, let's go.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor.
Alright, there we go. Put the nose down a tad. Flying helicopters and stuff like this is way faster to get around the this map. Actually, I want to have a quick look at the map. I want to see how big it is. Whoa, okay, whoa. Okay, so if we scroll out, we get to see all of these. Okay. So I take it we have to take all of the ones around the edge out before we get to the guy in the middle. Okay, and we're somewhere up there. Okay, that's actually pretty cool to have a look at. Whoops, I pressed the wrong button. So pretty much, we're in this area. Okay, dokie. Flying the helicopters is a bit weird from at times. Alright, we're pretty much here nearly. Alright, let's head on down. Okay, yeah, these helicopters are really clunky to fly. Okay, there we go, and we're down. It's just not running into the tail rotor or anything. And we'll grab this as well.
Awesome, I can put this to use.
Sweet, and now we've got a sniper rifle. That's where I got the sniper rifle from. It's always good to know that to pick up ammo too. We'll also customize that. Whoa, where are we going? Alright, let's extract. And then we'll talk more.
Are you hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si, Yuri Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock.
Alright. Okay, so it keeps on obviously telling us to,
Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through.
Well, we also got a, we leveled up too. Sweet.
That's
okay,
the
so
rundown
video
on
available.
Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
Guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall. Personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head Sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.
Alright, so we've now got a tutorial. We'll tap the tutorial and then we'll watch that. Okay, so... Alright, there. So it's pretty much just telling us how to gather intel and stuff like that. I already know how to do all of that. You find those on the map and you go there and take pictures and yada yada yada. We'll do that. Probably the next episode. I'm probably going to end it here anyway. Alright, so we'll watch this video. Here we go.
There were four people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last two were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchon named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop for 47 hours straight.
Wow.
They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
Alright, there we go. Right, so what we are going to do, guys, is, as it keeps on telling us to join co-op and stuff, right, what we are going to do is, I am going to change my submachine gun to a sniper rifle, because that will come in handy quite a lot. Hopefully we'll get more sniper rifles later on as we unlock more. But as of now, we've pretty much just got this, so, let's see if we've got any optics or anything. Alright, so let's do parts. Scope. Okay, we only have this scope and that's it. I really want like a proper sniper scope on it, but I guess we'll have to find it somewhere. Right. Another thing is I want to check out this and see if we've got any parts for this, which we do. Oh, we have a scope. Sweet. Okay, we'll just go with a simple sight. That should help us out quite a lot. Help us aim a little bit more and everything like that. Let's have a look at it, shall we? Yep, that helps us out a little bit more. Means we can aim on heads better. Let's have a look at this. Yep, there's our sniper rifle. Hasn't got the best range, but it'll do for now. And there's our pistol. I love how it goes in first person when you aim. But, yeah. Anyway, guys, what I'm going to do is I'm going to end this one here. I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys in the next one, which will continue from right here. I hope you like our guy. I hope he looks all right for you guys and everything like that. I kind of like this style. It's like kind of like a special ops outfit, I guess, I went for. But, yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. I will catch you guys in the next one, which I don't know when it'll be coming out, but this one will be coming out on day of release, hopefully. Which is, right now it's, Tuesday.
Nomad, I've got Pacatari on the line. Sounds like he needs our help.
Put him through.
I've got a phone call.
Hola, compadre. I have a problem in Itaqua, and Bowman says you might be able to help. My people need help. There have been many losses to the cartel, and the horrors inflicted by Yuri Polito have broken their spirit. The fires of revolution have almost gone out.
Spare me the rhetoric, Atari. Just tell me what you need.
There is a cartel supply convoy passing through the province soon. Capturing it would give my people much-needed supplies and restore their morale. Can you do this?
Consider it done.
We're taking orders from Pacatari now?
Atari needs this convoy. We are gonna give it to him. The more he depends on us to get shit done, the more we can get out of him in return.
Yep, that's exactly what I was thinking. But anyway, guys, yeah, I don't know when the next episode's coming out. I know this episode's coming out on Tuesday. Just quick recap what I just said before I got interrupted. But, yeah, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Hit that like button. Hit subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the bell if you want to be notified when I next upload my next video. And, yeah, I will hopefully see you guys in the next one. But until then, guys, see you guys then.
What the fuck are you doing, Morgan?